Hillary Rodham Clinton, along with our own Heather Hegedus. Heather.
Hi, Steve. I am here with Senator Hillary Rodham Clinton, who made the trip here today to bring in the good news here for the people in Owego. She was here 1 year ago, correct? And you actually took a ride in a U.S. 101.
Right. Well, I took a ride 1 year ago this month, and I was very impressed by the helicopter. I believe that if the decision were made on the merits, that Lockheed was going to win. And I also said, though, I would be with Lockheed and the people here no matter what happens. So I intended to be here, win, lose, or draw, and I'm thrilled because this means a lot to new jobs and economic growth in the Southern Tier, and it's a great tribute to the people here at Lockheed.
Senator Clinton, they joked on stage about your book. They said it takes a village to get a contract like this. And you've really called this Team New York. It's really been a bipartisan effort securing this contract. Tell me about that.
It has been Team New York, and we have worked together. It did take a village. It took, as they say, a global village, because this is going to be 90% made in America. But we're also going to be working with our allies in Great Britain and Italy, who have stood with us in the war against terror. It couldn't be a better decision. And when I talked to the Secretary of Navy, he made it very clear that the decision was based on the merits, that Lockheed put together a great proposal, and it's going to mean hundreds of new jobs here.
Certainly, as you mentioned, there was concern that the decision could be made on the history that Sikorsky has historically made these helicopters. Also, there was concern that they might have more political power in Washington. What does this say about Lockheed?
Well, I believed that we were due for a change. You know, I have a lot of experience flying on the presidential helicopter, and I could tell that the Lockheed proposal was a better product. It was just more suited to what the President of the United States needs in the 21st century. So I was very optimistic, but I knew we had to work. We worked hard every day. We talked to everybody that would listen to us. We made the case, and I'm just grateful that these jobs and this great honor is going to come to the Southern Tier. I mean, it is a real tribute to the people here at Lockheed.
Thank you very much, Senator Rodham Clinton, for speaking with us. Steve?
All right, Heather, spoken by someone who knows what it's like to ride in Marine One, the designation given to any helicopter and that the President of the United States is flying on, the next generation of which will be integrated, at least systems-wise, right here in Owego.